Snakes are highly derived carnivores that have successfully colonized practically all continents and have spread into almost all habitat types. For all carnivores, hunting behavior is critical to survival. But with the loss of legs, snake hunting behavior has become especially adapted. There are two major methods of hunting in snakes: constriction and venom. In this video, we focus on constriction. Before any prey can be subdued, it must first be located. An iconic behavior in snakes is tongue flicking. The tongue protrudes to capture odorants from the air that are then processed when the tongue is retracted and run across the vomeronasal organ located at the roof of the mouth. According to Dag Fu et al., snakes use long sweeping flicks to locate hidden prey and shorter brief flicks to track urine trails. Once prey is located, snakes use imaging systems for prey targeting. Besides normal sight, some snakes have a pit organ that detects infrared radiation and thus provides a thermal map to target prey. Once in striking range, the snake curls its anterior end into a characteristic S shape. Using its body weight as an anchor, powerful muscles launch the snake towards the prey. Grasping the prey in its mouth, the momentum of the strike is harnessed to throw constricting coils over the prey. The period of constriction and swallowing is a time of intense vulnerability for the snake. Because the snake lacks limbs and must swallow its prey whole, it is largely incapacitated for this period of time. To speed up the process of killing its prey, the snake times its constrictions with the prey's exhalation, squeezing extra air out of the lungs and preventing further breaths. A study conducted by Bobak et al. Found that constrictors are able to sense the heartbeat of their prey during constriction. Researchers are able to control the pressure and duration of constriction by varying artificial heartbeats in dead rats. Another way to reduce vulnerability while feeding is to reduce the number of times a snake must feed. Snakes have the unique ability to swallow prey many times the size of their head. Contrary to popular belief, snakes do not dislocate their jaw to feed. Instead, snakes have elastic cranial bones and ligaments, allowing their two lower jaws to move independently of each other. The snake walks its jaws along the prey to move the prey down the throat. The prey goes down head first, so it is less likely to get caught in the digestive system. Eating prey larger than the size of your own head prevents a problem of how to breathe. To combat this, snakes have evolved a protrusible glottis that can extend outside their mouth. This allows breathing to continue even when the oral cavity is full. Once the prey has cleared the oral cavity, muscular contractions of the esophagus and body wall push the prey through the digestive system, similar to squeezing a tube of toothpaste. Once the first bit of food reaches the stomach, the cells swell and blood flow increases to the system. The heart increases to 40% its original mass within 2 days, and the gut doubles or triples in weight overnight. This increase in surface area greatly reduces the time needed to digest prey and thus enhances their chances of survival. During the periods when the snake is not feeding, the digestive system atrophies and loses function. Snakes are truly wondrous creatures that have captured the imagination and attention of humans across our shared history. Whether fascination or phobia, an understanding of their biology gives a new sense of respect for these adaptive wonders slithering across the earth.
Said we tried.